Hi, welcome to Programming with Mesh. In this video, we want to introduce a SDK from VoxImplant that helps us to have audio call and video call in React Native. VoxImplant platform is the cloud solution for creating and enhancing communication applications. Their technology is built to create simple or complex apps and can scale as your communication needs do. Through more than 7 years of development, VoxImplant currently serves 30,000 customers and handles more than 1 billion calls per year. Unlike other communication API solutions, VoxImplant platform provides an integrated communications development experience that includes native serverless tools, many AI integrations, and a comprehensive set of APIs and SDKs for any platform. You can use their SDKs for all platforms like web, Android, iOS, React Native, Flutter, and Unity to add voice, video, and messaging to any kind of app. These communication technology solutions can be used in any business like e-commerce, on-demand, fintech, classifieds, or contact center. Now to get acquainted with how the VoxImplant React Native SDK works, in order to add audio and video calls to the app, we go to this repository that its link is in the description. Select this project and clone it. Well, I cloned the project and opened it. First, with the npm install or yarn install command, we install the project dependencies. Also, if you want to run the app on an iOS device, run the pod install command from the iOS folder. Now to test the app, we need two separate environments to run. I have opened two different Android emulators here, so that we can contact each other through one of the devices. Well, run the app and wait for the app to open on both devices. As you can see, the login screen opened on both devices. To test, we need to create a free developer account on the VoxImplant website. We can use this link to do this. Enter the three required items and then enter the verification code via email. Then we complete the required items as desired. Well, the account was created successfully. As you can see, there is a small amount in your account for the initial tests. To get started and understand how this service works, we can review this short tutorial together. I select this option so that we can make an automatic voice call to the app through our account. In this way, we first create an app and a scenario. Then we create a user and a rule. Finally, we test a voice call in the browser. Well, first we create the application. The application name will actually be a combination of your chosen name and your account username. Well, now we enter the application to create a scenario for our call. Here we specify the name of the scenario file. In the following, a predefined scenario is created for us. We review this content after making the call. So we save the script and then create a user so we can call with it. Save your username and password to use when making a call. So now we create a rule from here to make the call for us. In fact, in this rule, we want the scenario we created to be executed. Now from this section, we can make a call using the user we created. From here, we run the rule to run the scenario. As you can see, the call has been made.
This is the Vox Implant bot. Congratulations! You have successfully run your first scenario and completed the call to web app tutorial. Good luck in creating awesome apps. See you!
Well, as you heard, an audio file was played in the call. If we go to the scenario we created, you will see that this message is played as an audio file in this call. Then, after playing the file, the call is disconnected, and the audio file of the call is saved. From this section, you can see the history of recent calls. You can also reply or download the saved call file. This was just an explanation of how this service works, and you don't need these steps to test the React Native application. After creating an account, you can use this link to create a new application for testing that includes two users, a scenario, and a rule. Well, the application has been created, and now you can use the information of these two users to test the application. Save these passwords to use in login to applications. Here you can see the application created and its content. The scenario created in this application simply establishes a contact with another user. In the future, you can design your own scenario according to the available documents. Here you can see the created rule. And you see the two users that have been created. From this section, you can edit user information. Well, now I enter the first user information in one of the devices. As you can see in the login information hint, in this section we have to enter a combination of username, application name, and account username, which is how I do this. In this section, we enter the saved password of the same user. Well, we entered the main page correctly. Do the same for the second user on the other device. Now in the first device, we enter the username of the second user to contact another device. With this button, a voice call is made, and the second user doesn't see the image of the first user at first. As you can see on the other side, the call is made by the first user. And with this button, a voice call is established between two users. You can also use this button to make a video call. This is the first user image. In fact, this is the simulated image for the emulator selfie camera. And on the other hand, we answer visually. This is the second user image. And after a short time, two users see each other's image. Now, by referring to your account, you can see the information related to this call in the call history section. And of course, you can record the calls later by adding the code in the scenario. Well, now let's take a look at the code of this demo project to know how to use it in our project. First of all, you need to add this module to the project. In this folder, you will find the project codes. I will show you their most important files. In the manager folder, in the login manager file, you can find the function by which we identified the user. In the CallKit manager file, the rncallKit module is used to manage calls in React Native. And in the call manager file, the connection to the application we created in the user account is done through the VoxImplant SDK. And in the Screens folder, you can find the use of Call Manager on the Call Screen page. You can also read the document of this service in the React Native SDK section for more information. So there we go, we got acquainted with VoxImplant SDK for React Native to have audio call and video call in our app. Now if you enjoyed the video, please don't forget to like, comment, share, and subscribe, and I'll see you in the next video.